welcome to another Minecraft video. I've been making a lot of these recently. I don't know why, I've just been filling around redstone and stuff, so it's just like stuff I'd like to show off. Anyway, so basically, this is an automatic chicken farm that Mumba Jumba made. You know, go check his channel out to see the full tutorial, but, you know, there's chickens up here, they lay eggs, the eggs get sucked into these hoppers, dispensed by the dispenser, chickens all hatch as babies, actually. Then when they grow up, their heads slip into the lava, and they're cooked meat, and their feathers all go into this chest. Now, this is where this is what I have done to it. So basically, I've taken hoppers out of the bottom of the chest, and that I've added a filter. So only cooked chicken meat will go in here, and only feathers will go in here. Now it's a little bit slow. If like a lot of chickens grow up at the same time, it'll be a bit slow. But to sort of filter through the feathers, but it does work. And I haven't had anything go wrong with this system yet. So the comparator running from this hopper here, you know, going into this piston, which and I should only activate if there's feathers in there. If you know, like a cooked breast just goes through, then it shouldn't do anything. Anyway, so it'll extend that piston, finishing off this redstone line, which is a redstone clock, 2x4, with a comparator and a repeater. Then that'll go off from that redstone bit into a monostable stick, I do believe it's called. Anyway, so basically, this dropper will drop the item into this hopper. This hopper will then send the item back into the dropper, meaning that as long as there's an item in there, that'll keep doing that, and that all will feed into this, which is a comparator, repeater, bit of redstone, redstone torch. Redstone torch will turn off, unlocking this hopper, which will allow feathers to go through into this chest. And yes, it is imperfect, because yes, as you can see, there is one feather in there. I could probably do something to make it foolproof. If you get like some feathers, and then just put them all in there to make absolutely sure that no chicken gets through, you can do that. But just to show you how good this is, let's get some spawn. Spawn chickens. One stack of them. In there. So, as you can see, the feathers come in. Usually they come in first, which is really good, because that means there's practically no chance of meat getting through, even without this here. Oh, we did actually get one cooked chicken in. That's the first time I've seen this do that, actually. Okay, what's different now? Because I've not changed anything, and this is the first time even one piece of cooked chicken got through. Three there. Yeah, those hoppers are working properly. That's still... I don't know. I was probably getting in a minute, but that's the first time I've legitimately seen, like, feathers... raw chicken get into the feathers hopper. I'm just going to take all these out. Dump them in there. That should probably stop any chance of them helping me getting through, but who knows? Right. Spawn chicken. Yeah, we've got the set feathers coming in first. Hulk Meat's getting through. Yeah, no, Hooked Meat got through. So if you fill those slots with feathers, then absolutely no Cooked Meat should get through. And then even then, it is rare for Cooked Meat to get through. Well, like, I've done this four times now. One time, Meat got through. Like, seriously, testing this, I did it twice. Neither time, not one piece of Cooked Meat got through. So yeah, unless you have like a lot. Unless you you're on like PC and you've changed it so that you can have like 50,000 chickens in here, and then like they all lay eggs super fast, and then like all a bunch of chickens grow up at the exact same time, this system is gonna have like no trouble filtering out the items. Now, something I was thinking is that this could possibly make work in an item storage. This is as far as I've gotten so far. I'm probably gonna have to remove this line of hoppers because that might actually make things more difficult for me. But I might be able to get this to work in an item storage system. It will be slightly more complex, but it might work with a, you know, like filter, and then each chest having the item you want. But yeah, I'm gonna have to do a lot of work on this before it's even like right now it's just like in testing. Like, I'm just trying to see if I can get the basic concept of this working first before I expand this into a large storage system sorting device, and for that will take a while. So don't expect to see a video on how to make this into a large item sorter anytime soon, if at all, because like even here I'm having a bit of trouble, having all the things here. So I might, you know, if you have any ideas for how I could make this easier on me, go ahead and put them down in the comment section. But so far it should be working. I don't know. I haven't tested it, but I really don't have the means to test it yet because I need to have. So basically, what I'm going to do is have two hoppers coming off. Two lines of hoppers coming off here, like the main line going down here into that chest, and then a line coming off this chest going into the second line of hoppers, and then feeding into like the back of this chest or wherever. But first I would need to like get comparators coming out of these chests, and then measuring the comparators so that as soon as a single item gets put in there, because none of these are stackable because I've named them, as soon as like a single item goes into either of these chests, the thing will come on, unlocking the hoppers underneath these chests. But like I said, I'm probably gonna have to get rid of that line of hoppers, and just like do some working with this, and eventually I should be able to make a very long but hopefully functional item sorting device. Just because I'm doing this in Bedrock currently, and because Redstone has changed a bit, I can't really be bothered to look up like multiple tutorials or multiple sorting devices just for like half of them to not work. So currently this does work in Bedrock. And try it out in Java, Puppet Edition, Console Edition, you know, every edition you got, if you want to, and see if it works. But it should work in every edition. The timings might need a bit of changing, but it should work. Anyway, I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye bye.